Reserve, 150 square miles of unspoiled habitat in South Africa. For many of these animals, this watering hole is critical to their survival. But in drought years, it can turn into a life-sucking pit.
We got to the waterhole about 7 in the morning. It was still very quiet and cool.
Tinus von Staden and his family are wildlife enthusiasts. The day they arrive, the pit is filled with mud. Suddenly, they spot a one-ton giant circling the mud pit.
There was a black rhino cow running around at the water's edge, very aggressive, chasing everything away that came even close to it, even birds.
Then Tinus' son, Marnus, spots the reason the mother is so frantic, her baby.
And the baby rhino was also distressed, screaming all the time.
It's critical that this baby survive, because tragically there are only about 3,000 of these black rhinos left in all of Africa.
Black rhinos have become endangered because of their horn. Poachers actually go out and kill them. A round horn could fetch possibly $250,000. That's a lot of money. That's why poaching continues.
It's far too dangerous for the family witnessing all this to attempt a rescue on their own. So Tinus von Staden goes for help. By the time the park ranger arrives, mama's missing and the youngster's in bad shape.
My adrenaline was really pumping then.
Realizing he needs help, Dirk drives off to get reinforcements. And he returns with more brave men. While some of the men try to free the baby, others hide in trees and watch out for the mother.
They started clapping their hands and shouting.
Unlike the horns of most animals, which have a bony core and are attached directly to the skull, rhino horns grow from the skin and are made of keratin, a fibrous material found in human fingernails. And when a rhino charges, they can be lethal.
Think about the force of a 3,000-pound animal driving a pencil point towards your body.
The men decide to tie a rope around the baby and use the truck to drag it out. With the men pulling and Dirk's truck tugging on the tow line, the mud pit finally surrenders the baby. But the danger isn't over just because the baby is on its feet.
We're so happy that we got this baby rhino out of the mud that we totally, in a way, forgot about the female black rhino that was nearby.
As the baby wails pitifully for its mom, the rescuers try to remove the ropes. Suddenly,
mom's coming!
And when someone shouted that the black rhino is coming, we all got a boost of adrenaline, so we all had to think of taking cover pretty quickly.
The men clap and shout to scare her off. It's working.
I think she was so intimidated by all the activity that she kind of retreated into the bush. We couldn't still see her at that stage.
Now that the baby is free, the baby trots to join up with its mom.
They both ran off into the bush, and it was quite an emotional moment for everyone.
It's a small victory for this family, but big picture, it's really so much more.
One rhino plays an important genetic contribution. Should this rhino breed and pass on offspring, it's very important for us to the continued success of rhino reproduction in Africa.